Gamers, rejoice, because in iOS 14.5, you can finally use the Sony PlayStation 5 DualSense Controller with your iPhone, iPad, and Apple TV. Here is how to pair it and what you can do with your new PlayStation Controller. So to set up your own PlayStation 5 DualSense Controller with your iPhone, iPad, or Apple TV, you need just a couple things. You need the DualSense controller itself. You got a link for these down below in the description if you don't have one yet and want to grab one. And then you're gonna need an iPhone, iPad, or Apple TV running the latest update. That means you need iOS 14.5, iPadOS 14.5, or tvOS 14.5. Now currently, those updates are in developer beta testing, which means not everyone has access to them. Soon, they'll be out in public beta where anyone can download them early ahead of a full release. So either way, you need 14.5 or newer for your iPhone, iPad, or Apple TV to use the DualSense controller. So make sure you keep that in mind as you decide or try to figure out how to pair your controller with your mobile device. Okay, so you've got 14.5 installed on your iPhone and you've got your DualSense controller. Where do we go from there? It is easy. So first, you're going to need to go into your iPhone and go into the Settings app. Then you're going to venture down and tap on Bluetooth and watch for there at the bottom of the list where it says Other Devices. That is where your controller is going to appear when we put it into pairing mode. To do that, we're going to jump over to our DualSense controller here, and you're going to hold two buttons at the same time. You're gonna hold that black button in the center, that little PlayStation icon, the PS icon. You're gonna hold on to that PlayStation icon and the share button, which is located in that upper left-hand corner. Hold those two buttons down and continue to hold them until the light bars on either side of the touchpad start to flash blue. Pretty typical Bluetooth pairing mode. It just flashes blue, pulses blue. That means it's in pairing mode, and we're gonna go back over here to our iPhone. And if we look at our iPhone, there at the bottom under Other Devices, we should see our controller appear. It'll say DualSense controller, tap on that, and you're done. It'll now show up in your list just like all your other things. DualSense wireless controller, tap the little eye, you can see the name, disconnect or forget the device. You can do that, and of course you go back to your PlayStation, just plug it back in with the cable and tap the PS button, it'll boom, boot right up just like it normally does. No issues whatsoever. So you can use it on your PlayStation 5, you can use it here on your iPhone, your iPad, or your Apple TV that easily. But there is more that I want to talk about, and this is really amazing. So with this new 14.5 update, Apple has even added the ability to customize what this controller does over on your iPhone and iPad. And that includes that new share button. If you use that share button, you can press it once, just hold it for a second, and boom, you can see it takes a screenshot. So you're playing the game, hold it down, take a screenshot that easily. You don't have to go into Control Center and hit two buttons together. No, boom, take it, done, screenshot. Your other option is double tap it, click it twice, and that's gonna start a screen recording. As you can see here in Oceanhorn, I tap it twice and I have a little pop-up. It's a little blurry in the background, but it does ask me if I want to allow screen recording. You have to do that once. But once you do that, just double tapping that guy is gonna start a screen recording and do it again to stop. And then you can share that clip wherever you want, social media, YouTube, Twitter, whatever. Easily share your pictures or in-game recordings. But if we go down into settings, then general, there's a new option for game controller there. I can see the name of my controller that I currently have connected. I can disable that haptic feedback. I can disable screenshots and I can disable screen recording. So I can turn off any of those that I want. But customizations is what's really cool. I can go ahead and do this for the entire system. So I can change what the X button does or the cross button. I can change what the touchpad button does, or I can even change touchpad with first finger versus second finger. There's a lot of really cool stuff that you can do, but you can remap those to different things. So I can maybe change my joystick to the directional pad control. Anything like that, the R3 buttons, like toggling them with the L3 and R3, those things are controllable. And you can do this on a per app basis. So games that support these controllers, you can customize it. So I can go into Oceanhorn, and maybe just in Oceanhorn, I want that circle button to be mapped to L1 or whatever it is I want to map it to. But I can do that on a per app basis. I mean, if you don't use the touchpad in the game, map that to something. And if you get really quick access to a button that maybe you don't reach as easily or want to grab with the other hand, it's super cool. So I love the fact that you can customize this and remap those buttons through the OS or in apps as a whole. It is really awesome. So I am thrilled so far with DualSense support inside of iOS 14.5. So check it out. Go play your greatest games, PUBG, Call of Duty, Oceanhorn, SpongeBob, whatever it is that you want to use. Use your DualSense controller, try it out, and let me know over on Twitter what you think at Andrew_OSU.